Now, the US election, just days away now. I hope you're excited. I know I'm certainly excited. You'd remember, of course, these comments yesterday from Joe Biden about Trump supporters.
The only garbage I see floating out there is his supporters.
Well, Trump hit back today in the best way possible with a garbage truck.
That's like deplorable for Hillary. This is the deplorable for Hillary. And I think this is worse, actually.
Honestly, I just love that there's some fun in politics again. I mean, here we are in Australia going on about whether the PM is effectively corrupt for getting flight upgrades. And over in the US, they're slinging mud and driving around in garbage trucks. The content is just chef's kiss. He then went from the truck to a rally in Green Bay in Wisconsin, still wearing his high-vis vest.
You can't lead America if you don't love Americans. That's true. You can't be president if you hate the American people, which I believe they do.
Now, the problem for Harris here is that she still has to show some kind of respect to her president. He is still her boss, don't forget. So she has to find a way to say that she doesn't think half the country is garbage without effectively saying that Biden is an idiot. Now, this was her attempt. I'm not sure it quite hit the mark.
First of all, he clarified his comments. But let me be clear, I strongly disagree with any criticism of people based on who they vote for.
So what is it? Are you repudiating your president or not? Good luck with that one. And speaking of Biden, we know he has done some weird things. You know, he's got this thing about stiffing people's hair and trying to kiss people and generally being a bit of a creep. And never forget the one about kids stroking his legs and sitting on his lap.
And by the way, you know, I sit on the stand and it get hot. I got hairy legs that turn blonde in the sun. And the kids used to come up and reach in the pool and rub my leg down so it was straight and then watch the hair come back up again. They'd look at it. So I learned about roaches. I learned about kids jumping on my lap. And I've loved kids jumping on my lap.
I mean, blimey, Charlie. Anyway, he's added to the repertoire today. Now, you know the old joke, I love kids, but I couldn't eat a whole one. You might remember he gave it a go a year ago. Well, he decided to have another shot today. He had a Halloween party at the White House and he decided to chomp on a baby dressed as a chicken. Now, forgive me, but you might say it was a cock-up. I think this was probably the look he had after he realised that wasn't dinner. Meanwhile, the left in America seem to think that if a woman votes for Trump, it must be because she's under the thumb of some controlling husband who makes her vote for Trump. No, a woman couldn't possibly vote for Trump of her own volition, could she? Women must vote for other women. Take a look at this ad from campaign group Vote Common Good, voiced by Julia Roberts.
Your turn, honey.
In the one place in America where women still have a right to choose, you can vote any way you want, and no one will ever know.
Did you make the right choice?
Sure did, honey.
Remember, what happens in the booth stays in the booth. Vote Harris Walz.
I mean, what? Did you make the right choice? Sure did, honey. I mean, I genuinely thought that was a skit the first time I watched it. And they may well be worried, because in 2020, married women voted for Trump over Biden-Harris 52-47%. I mean, as if women don't know that they can vote for who they want. That's the point of a secret ballot. But it goes to show you exactly what Harris and her mates think of conservative men, that they're controlling scumbags who force their wives to vote a certain way and that conservative women mustn't really think that way. They're just under the thumb of their awful husbands. You're garbage or you're some kind of domestic abuser, apparently. And before we move on to other things, there's a great behind-the-scenes documentary of the Trump campaign that's been made by an outfit called Ashokan Studios. You can find it on X. It's called Art of the Surge. Take a look at this. This is Trump reacting live to Harris's address at the DNC a few months ago.
Thank you.
Is she crazy?
Thank you. Thank you all. Wow. Thank you so very much. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, everyone. Thank you.
Oh, too many thank yous.
It's about 20.
There must be 35.
Traveling from India to California with an unshakable dream to be the scientist.
How many people are watching?
Can we tell how many, Dan? How many people are watching?
She's talking about how great San Francisco was before she destroyed it.